I'm a marketing rebel, marketing rebel.
Hey, what's going on? Nate Kennedy here with Marketing Rebels, where we talk business, marketing, and money. And today I want to break down what I believe one of the biggest mistakes that entrepreneurs make when they get started. So here's the thing. In business, when you're starting out, you start seeing what other people are doing, but you don't really know their past. You don't know where they started, how they started, how long they've been doing it, any of that stuff, right? So what I find is I see entrepreneurs, they're trying to go from 0 to 100 instantaneously and get the result. They want to be where they're at now today to where they see other people at that took them 10, 15 years to get there, and they're trying to do it within a month. So one of the biggest things is, because of that, it causes a lot of entrepreneurs to try and expand quickly. So what do I mean by that? So you hear a lot of people, myself included, talk about multiple streams of income, right? And you see other companies talking about, other entrepreneurs, other marketers talking about how to have multiple streams of income, how to build multiple businesses. It's funny because you always see it in the profile. We have it in ours. I'm building multiple seven-figure companies, or you see someone who's like, you know, owner of 8 different brands or companies, right? So that's the thing. Those things didn't happen overnight. That happened over time. So what I want to talk to you about, how you can get there and how you can do it quicker without all of the challenges, issues, and frustration. So they didn't start there. It took years to get there, right? So when you see this stuff on social media and you see these things said, understand that it took time. They had building blocks. What you'll be better served doing is maximizing the current business you have. You're going to be better served financially. You're going to be better served mentally, focusing on growing the current business to get it to a point where you are financially stable, you are cranking and growing at a healthy rate on a yearly basis. That is going to help you get to the process and get to the point where you can build other companies. So how do you maximize what you currently have? First off, you stop looking at all the other opportunities out there and stop thinking about, you know, you start having the FOMO, right? You got to stop the FOMO, fear of missing out on a different opportunity. What you really need to do is focus on the one that you have in front of you. The grass isn't greener on the other side. The grass is greener where you water it at the end of the day. So what you want to do is put that time, energy, and effort, if you're starting out a new business, and go in. So what are ways that you can maximize your business? Well, you can find bolt-on opportunities. You can create a new product line. You can create a new offer. These are things you can do, but bolt-on opportunities for the audience that you already own. So for example, product businesses are able to add the one-step funnel to their business to help them acquire over 1,000 leads a day pretty consistently. So what does this solve? When they bolt this onto their company, it helps them build a bigger email list that they can market to. It helps them build different audiences. So what this allows them to do as well is kind of, I don't want to say circumvents, maybe not the right word, but it allows you to not fall victim to the ad account declines based on the way the one-step funnel goes and grows an audience for you for your product business already. So bolt-on opportunities for product businesses as well. Number one is the one-step funnel opportunity. Number two option could be your demographics, right? All of our audiences, all of our businesses have specific people and specific demographics of people that buy different product lines. So you might be able to, on a bolt-on opportunity, go find a person who has a product in your niche that you don't sell, and you can promote that to them as an affiliate. So that becomes an opportunity if you generate additional revenue inside your business. Now, the next thing you can do is new traffic sources. So a lot of times people build their business on one traffic source. And when you build your business on one traffic source, if you're trying to scale to a new level, it's very difficult because that traffic source could get shut off instantaneously. And now you're up Schitt's Creek, right? Trying to figure out what to do next. So you don't want to be there. So new traffic sources give you an opportunity to expand. So maybe you start with Facebook, but then you can move to YouTube, you can move to display, you can build a more well-rounded acquisition strategy for your business. And now once you get that stuff done, dialed in and working for you, and as I mentioned, you get these things and you really maximize all that stuff around that company, the way that you're gonna grow into new organizations, a new company, there's one of two ways to do it. Well, to expand, right? To add multiple streams of income or multiple other businesses. And you're either gonna do all the work yourself, so you have to get your core business put in place to where it's actually functioning, growing, and effective, or you're gonna have to find great people. So the people that I find that try to do it all the work themselves, and don't ask me how I know, I plead the fifth, but I have done that myself before, right? So, and the big lesson for me was you can't do it all yourself, no matter how much you try. You're gonna end up overworking yourself, stressing yourself out, and not liking the end result that you were shooting for. So the best way of going about it is to find great people to work with you, right? And as you find good people, you can move into other opportunities. That's the number one way great companies grow, is in the ways that you can do this. Now, it doesn't have to be, you don't have to find great people all in just one way. There's multiple ways that you can do it. You can find great people. First off, it starts with building a culture. That's something we're implementing more and more internally for our company. Another great way of finding people, if you have someone that works with you, is doing a great job, they can also might have referrals for someone to come in. So there's different ways to find great people. One is, are you building a culture that people want to be a part of? Are you building an environment that they want to come work for? If you are, the people that work with you might bring referrals and know other great people looking for opportunities. And then there's all the job boards. There's Craigslist, there's Indeed, and all the other job boards that are out there. And another way, if you have your other business dialed in already, you can invest some of that profit that you're generating to go acquire other companies with great people. So sometimes it's not always hiring one person at a time. Sometimes you acquire another company that fits the business model that you're looking to add to your portfolio, is one way to go about it. So with that said, in this video, what I want you to do is understand that take care of your core business first. Get it exactly where you want it. Expand, get it working, get the right people in place so the thing is able to grow and you don't have to manage every last little detail inside the business. You don't really want to be doing that, because the reason and the way that myself and the people that I work with, and a lot of people I don't even know that have multiple companies, they do it one way. There's the people that do it, well, they do it two ways. They do it the hard way, where they do all the work themselves and they get burnt out. But the people that really start adding multiple companies, they do it because they have great people. So start focusing on how you can actually build multiple, take care of business one. So that's a whole saying of don't quit your day job. Once you have that rolling, then you move into business number two, and then you get more people for that and you continue to grow it. So I just wanted to share that with you. If you gain value from this video, do me a favor. Like the video, share the video, do something to share the message out there with someone else that could gain value from this. So I appreciate your time. If you got any questions, leave it in the comments below. Thank you.